Hello everyone. Today we're gonna talk about something different. So there's this person, he's called he, she, it, they, whomever. It's called Satoshi Nakamoto, and he's the creator of Bitcoin, and no one knows exactly who he is. Apparently, those are some dates that he has, and he has like an identity as well to it, and he created the whole idea of Bitcoin. So there was an article came out by Investing in Blockchain, which suggests that maybe Paul Satoshi Calder de Roux could be the same person because he is the inventor of true crypto cryptographic software. And he could be theoretically be him. The reason why that is because he is involved in certain drug conflicts, and a way of faking out or trying to not use literal normal ways of money is by using a alternative currency. And he has 1 million bitcoins that would be on his name because of the beginning of the Bitcoin ledger. He was mining a lot of it, he or she or whoever. And if it could be him. And yeah, the first thing, like, he is called Solotshi. Second thing is he's a very good programmer in C++, and a good programmer in C++, which is the same language as like Bitcoin. Bless, he disappeared in 2010, and he also got into prison at the same time, no, 2011, I'm sorry. And yeah, and even the writing and the idea of against the government is kind of like the same. Yeah, they have similar spelling and language. So if you look at the email history, for example, it shows that in 2008, on the 10th, like in October, first email about Bitcoin was released. And if you are on the Wikipedia page, you can see that in August 2008, a passport of Satoshi Calder Roux, Paul, like first name, has been given, and that's like a little bit concerning. And actually, let me. This is okay. On Christmas of 1982, and here he would be a little bit older on the claims, because this is claimed on the Bitcoin forum store. So, yeah. And if you look at the market right now, we see that we were in this very, this is on a Bitcoin on a weekly market. We see this very bearish fill, like we fell off a cliff basically here. And then we bounced through the resistance that we had about around 6,000, and we got all the way up to 9,000. Yeah, actually with 9,000. And if you compare it to the last bear market, you could be almost saying it that like this was like the first line I had here, and maybe, and this would be like extreme bearish scenario, the other line would be like the other resistance thing would be here. And the third one that we are basically approaching right now would be here. So we have those three, like we have always this like small resistance pattern here in the lower part. We have the upper resistance here, which is after like a big drop off, and the bottom, which was put here. So if you compare it here as well, it's like a little bit longer because the bigger Bitcoin gets, the longer those bear and bull markets last. So again, we have the bottom here now, we dropped out of it, and then we would go back down. So in a way it would look like something like, let me just try to draw it correctly here. So something like, let's get me, so we drop back off, would go here, fall below it, go up a little bit, fall below, go up, fall below, and then the third time we test, we would have a actual bull market. So let me just, yeah. So we'd have the actual bull market. So basically this, go down below, go up, go higher, and down below again. And that could be the one idea of how this whole thing turned out. And to be honest, if the media would find out and confirm now that the real identity of Satoshi Nakamoto would be Paul Roux, I think this would be a very bad result for the Bitcoin community, because the main person who is inside, or like who invented this whole idea, is suddenly a person. And if you take a look at all the other cryptocurrencies, like Ethereum with Vitalik, with Bitcoin Cash with Vorderbeer, with Litecoin with Charlie Lee, with Bitcoin shit vision is Craig Wright. The problem is kind of that there are always those people on the top that are known, and with Bitcoin this isn't the case yet. But if this theory about Paul Roux turns to be true, I think, yeah, people would be in a pretty bad shape, or at least the Bitcoin idea itself. So it would take a few more years for this bear market and this accumulation zone that actually happened back here, which took like, well, it took like 1 year at least. So I wonder why we also wouldn't take at least 1 year in this like lower part here. So yeah, this was just my thoughts on this whole idea, and I definitely recommend to look at this article by Investing in Blockchain, and they're actually stating very interesting comments about that. So yeah, maybe their idea is biased and they're more into altcoins and they want to see Bitcoin fail like everyone does in the main media. But yeah, here are my two cents. So yeah, thank you very much.